thrilled that you're here. Really today, I mean, it's about a couple of things, but more importantly, it's about celebrating, you know, the relationship that's starting between Mikasa, who you all know and love, and Sony ATV Music Publishing. Now, while it's a celebration, it's also going to be an opportunity for us as journalists to sort of get an understanding about what the deal is really about and what's really the difference between publishing deals and recording deals. But I suppose we'll deal with that more when we do our Q&A later. So what we'll do, we'll have a chat and you'll get to hear from the guys and you'll get to hear from Roland, and they'll tell you about what this thing is, you know, what it took to get here and how beautiful it's going to be going into the future. All right?
For sure.
And yeah, because I really think it's a big deal, and we need to take a moment to really think about the implications, because we know a whole history of places where people didn't think about this bit of the business and it didn't go so well. So this is groundbreaking in that it's educational as well for a lot of us. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce Roland Nyker, who's the dude meister, you know, the director here at Sony Publishing South Africa, and he'll basically take us through the whole thing. And then at the end of it all, we'll, so you can prepare your questions, we'll open the ground for Q&As. I know all of you have a lot to ask. All right. So, Roland.
Yeah. Thank you. Thanks, Percy, for that.
Sure.
Yeah, greetings to all of you. Wow, I mean, it's a full house. It's, you know, it's really nice to have you all here. And so welcome, and thank you for accepting the invite. Just to start off by just saying that we're very excited, you know, just to be at this place at this time. You know, it's been a process kind of getting here. To be exact, it probably took about, I think it's about 18 days short of an entire year of kind of, you know, working through details and back and forth, and a lot of learning curves between, I think, all of us here on the side as part of the process. But just so thankful to have been here today. And maybe just to say that, obviously, I'm sure a few of you or many of you maybe guess, like, you know, what this is about, so like, what's all the hype? But I think just from my side, it's just, I mean, we've got, for us, it's very exciting, and like, we want to scream it from the rooftops. And hey, a deal doesn't happen until like you guys talk about it and photograph it, and so that kind of like makes it really more concrete. And so therefore, we invited you guys here today. I think there's you know, a couple reasons why this deal. Oh, so maybe let me just to say, so officially, I'm able to announce that Mikasa has signed a global publishing deal with Sony ATV. And yeah, we're just, thank you. Yeah, we're over the moon about that. And I mean, I just to maybe just introduce, and maybe we'll get you thinking around other things. Like Percy said, I mean, there's possibly some time for some one-on-ones afterwards and answering some questions. But you know, this deal is really important to us for a number of reasons. I think first one is that, you know, they're an amazing band with just an amazing presence, amazing music, and it really adds value to not just our local roster, but in fact our global catalog as well. So we're thrilled about that as well. And you know, it's we all know and love Mikasa, the recording artist, the performing artist on stage, and that's superb. But for us as publishers, the mic.
Who wants to record?
Okay, maybe did a few of us. Sorry. Yeah, I mean, we acknowledge them as fantastic, amazing recording artists, as performing artists, and for us as publishers, you know, we believe that they need to be celebrated and elevated in terms of their songwriting and composer abilities. Thank you. And we believe that that's a reason to celebrate and honor them in this moment. Yeah, just look at my
Your crib notes.
My crib notes, yeah. I've got a lot of highlights, a lot of yellow highlights. Can you see that? Yeah, I mean, we get an opportunity to promote, pitch, and license their amazing hits around the world. And through our network, we get to connect them with, you know, other esteemed songwriters like themselves from, you know, from our catalog of international guys as well. And I just think that's something that, you know, we celebrate. We celebrated it from in our continent, and, you know, we just can't wait for, you know, to just really get out there and explore opportunities. And I think, you know, most importantly, I just want to say that we're thrilled to have these three talented composers, singer-songwriters in our presence and as part of us. And I think they're meant to be celebrated. You know, they're gifted, they're talented, they're creative. And I think more than that, what even supersedes that is that they're so humble and genuine and amazing human beings, and I'm just so looking forward to the opportunity to really build on this relationship and take it to the next level. And I think, yeah, just with all of that being said, I think, you know, if we could just maybe just get our glasses, and while I probably pop some of this bubbly, it's probably the best part of my job. Can I just say that?
Oh yeah.
And we can
grab this mic from you.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, and so we can, you know, like officially
open the other one, huh?
Yes.
Do the your turn now.
Yeah, guys. I mean, I think if you don't mind, in this time while we're doing this, if you can also get your glasses as well.
Get your glasses.
Get your drinks.
Ready.
Don't be shy.
Oh, right. Whoa! Is it? Yes.
Here we go.
Who's going? I'm still good, Jim.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, please, guys. There's more glasses. Are there more? I think there are more glasses on the front.
I've had two of these. I'm already going. Is it over to us?
So, are we still getting some glasses?
Let's make sure that those glasses are poured. Let's pour some glasses here. Come, my brother, let me help you out, my man. At your service, sir. Is it cool there?
Thank you. I think there were more champagne glasses behind where Mpumi was.
Keep the drinks and coming.
Brilliant ad for Moe, yeah? This is I hope they gave you guys this champagne for free.
What do you think?
No.
Yeah.
We paid for this. Yeah.
All right, guys. So,
do you want me to pour more or what?
Are they still busy?
Fine.
They're still busy.
Are we good?
Yeah, we're good. Honors to you. Okay. So with all of that being said, I'd just like to say to Dr. Dieter.
Oh yeah.
Say something.
Moti.
Yo.
Yes,
man.
And we just hope and trust that this would be your home sweet home for the longest time.
Yes.
And that all's left to say is that we officially welcome you to the Sony ATV familia.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Well done, fam. Hey.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, listen, we're honored and privileged to have you with us, and yeah, to greater heights.
Thank you.
And I just would also in this time just like to just to say thank you to Sergio.
Sergio.
Yeah.
Hey.
Like I said, it's been a year in the making. He's been an absolute gem to work with, and thank you for all your hard work during this process as well.
Cheers.
So yeah, cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Cheers,
everyone.
And then I guess it's you guys
want
to say something?
Yeah, we'd love to say something. Yeah. I think that the first thing that I started to, I'm going to speak on our behalf. I've been asked to be the speaker on our behalf. So I just wanted to say that I think for the longest time in our careers, we got freaked out by being called celebrities because we never really felt like celebrities because we never really fitted in with the other celebrities because we were all really just about the music.
Yeah.
Until we realize what celebrities mean, which is it's to be celebrated by somebody. And I think one of the greatest feelings is to be celebrated by people. And it's such a refreshing feeling for us in our career, in our 7-year career, to kind of have this new level of excitement about being aligned with us, you know, from a publishing point of view, and I think just from a general point of view.
Yeah.
I think this deal for us is a very, very important deal for us, for many reasons, but I think one of the main reasons why it's so important for us is because for those of you guys that know who we are and what we do, we are all about music. And I think that what everybody sees on the cameras is the glamour of music, which is the hit songs, the great performances, and all that jazz, which is all the important things, and I think the things that kind of make you famous. But I think one of the things that not a lot of people know about Mikasa is the amount of talent that is hidden within the band.
Yeah.
We have never ever recorded a record that is not our own, 100%.
Yes.
We've never ever not written any of our own lyrics, produced any of our own things. We always make sure that we do that. And I think as musos, one of the things that we've kind of have a newfound respect for is the amount of craft that goes into making what we do. And publishing is at the core of that. Publishing is your first copyright,
that's
as you
it.
Mentioned, Roland.
That's
it's
it.
The first, that's before it. A song becomes anything that you know, it's actually a material of work that has got its first copyright, and that's where it starts. So I think for us to be aligned with Sony ATV internationally is in line with what we're trying to achieve as a band. I don't know how many of you know what we've achieved, but we've achieved quite a lot over the last couple of years, all the accolades and all that jazz, but I think that we've also brought a lot of people together, and I think we've brought a lot of happiness into a time where maybe a little bit of happiness was needed. I think that when you think of Mikasa, you think about happiness and, you know, humility and positivity and all that things. We've had the privilege to share that message in 34 African countries over the last 3-4 years, Europe tours and America and all these type of things, and we've performed everywhere in South Africa. So I think for we've done 4 albums with I don't know how many hits on the albums. We don't even count really, but I think that one of the things that we're really excited about is, and which is refreshing, is to be excited about getting into studio again.
Yes.
Because when you used to make music, you used to make music thinking, I need a hit song so that I can get onto radio, so that people can book me, so that I can make money off bookings. And that's really how most musicians think. It's just, how do I make a hit song so that I can get booked for December, and so that I can be fine and try and buy a car or whatever it is that people want to do, you know? But I think that to be excited about making a song that can have people that are excited about using that song to make money as a whole new revenue stream, which is something that we haven't really been accustomed to in the last 6-7 years. You know, we kind of were just going with the flow. So I think it's very refreshing for us. And I think finally, I think from myself, Duda and Mo, we just wanted to stretch out a huge thanks to Sergio, who's been with us since the beginning of our career, you know? A thing that you'll see a lot of us like feeling really emotional about this, and I know that for you guys it's something that it's part of your job, you know. This is part of our lives, you know. This is our livelihood, this is how we feed our families, this is how we carry our kids, and this is how we support one another. And Mikasa is a very tight-knit family. We're not about the hey look at me, I'm the star, whatever. We about doing what we love with the craft, that the talents that we've been given, and using that to help one another to achieve our dreams. So Sergio, thanks so much for all the input that you've put. Since the beginning of the brand, Sergio's been with us since we started. We went to him
when we needed our first outfit for our first performance, which was used for every single performance for a couple of months. But now here we are, you know, signing a huge deal for us with Sony ATV. And I think thank you to you, Roland, and your team for just the amount of enthusiasm that you guys have shown towards our brand. It's just so refreshing for us. And we're so excited about taking over the world with you guys and seeing where life takes us. And I really believe that God has blessed this band. And I really believe that God has got a unique plan for this band, and that's been shown in how it's grown over the years. So we're very excited about wherever God wants to take us and wherever life wants to take us. But so far, it's been a pretty damn good journey. 7 years down the line, four or five albums down the line, we're still getting Sama nominations and all these type of things, which for us is like bizarre, but we're very, very thankful for all these things. So I think for you guys, media people, I think that we always get thanked by media people for showing up to an interview or doing things, and we always feel bad for you guys thanking us, because it's you guys that we need to thank for spreading the message and spreading the love and spreading the news, because that's the only way people find out about these things. So thank you for being here. It's very overwhelming to see so many of you guys here, and thank you for sharing the news with us, and thank you for sharing a very special moment in our career with us. And yes to many more hit songs and beautiful songs that get used all over the world.
Sure.
Cool, man.
Like I said, 2011 to now, you guys are rolling, you guys are good, you're traveling the world, and obviously you feel like there must be growth. So how do you then guys decide that, how does this deal come about, essentially?
I think, man, from like way back 5 years ago, when we started, you know, we started as like three individuals. So we had to, you know, deal with each other, like differences all the time, and Some things we never like brought them to the table and say this is wrong and this is right, simply because we were respecting each other all the time. So I guess that's one of the things that kept us going all the time, just the respect, you know. So, and obviously as a family, we grew up as a family, and then family you fight, and if you don't talk about it, it's a problem, you know. So we've had like so many things that were under the carpet, like shouts, just to for us to keep cool. Okay, no, this is right, we're not going to fight because it's going to break us. You know? So it ended up being a, you know, poison to everyone of us. You know? So, but then we sat down, we talked about it, you know, like, we came in as like girlfriends and boyfriends, like, oh, we need to do 1, 2, 3. I was scared of the girlfriend.
Who's the girlfriend?
That's how you just
said it. Who's the girlfriend?
So yeah, man, and then we were like, there's one thing that we so good at it is making good music. So let us just be together, stay together, do good music. So obviously, a business decision was made to be, you know, to be done and stuff. Because for the past 7 years, we've been like, you know, hustling, and some of the things we didn't know properly, because we were getting it like in the wrong way. Someone's telling us in a different way, you know, until the 7 years, we like, okay, this is the way to go. But we needed someone to go with, you know, and to this serious business, you know, thing, decision. So, yeah, that's why we we're here today. And so,
so who gets the call? Like, yo, guys, this is happening. Yo, let's meet this guy. How does the whole thing come about?
You mean like for this deal specifically?
For this deal specifically. No.
Well, I think one of the things that we've done really well as a band is we've made sure that we've stuck to what we do best. And I think it's a very important thing to do when you are in business. It's like, understand what are your skills and what are your good things, and then stick to that. And why I mention that is that what we're really good at as a band is making music. And then what we've done really well since day one is make sure that we're surrounded by people that actually know what they're doing. So when we speak about this deal with Sony, the amount of impact that we've had as three individuals on this deal is actually quite minimal. It's actually been based on the incredible management that we've got as a team, and more specifically, I think Sergio, who's been with Mikasa since day one, since the very, very beginning. And he's really had a lot to do with this deal and making sure that it's perfect, that it's fair for everybody involved, and making sure that it's worth the while, you know. So, and then also, you know, Roland and Sergio have really been pioneers in bringing this together and coming to life. That's why it's taken so long, because it's been a journey to try and get it right, to make sure that everybody's happy and that it's fair.
All right, cool. So the deal comes through at Sony, you guys hear the news, and you see the roster of music writers, of producers, of anyone at Sony that you have now access to. What excites you about that roster? Who is that person that you want to, like, oh shit, now we can work with this guy? Who's that guy?
Well, man, I think now it's a bit too early to tell, man. But, you know, I know that, like, the whole list is endless. But now we're just also just, you know, trying to settle in, you know. And now we're just enjoying these sweets here, right here, man. You know, enjoying, you know, everything that's in the house right now. Before we can get out and actually meet the rest of the fam, you know. But I know the list is endless. Some great guys out there. And, yeah, man, within the 5 years, and even if it's more, but we're looking forward to working with these great guys, you know. So, yeah, bro.
I'm not gonna let you get away with that, dude. I mean, there's Cardi B, there's Shake, there's Calvin Harris, there's Lady Gaga, there's Pink, there's Shakira, Ed Sheeran, Sia, Sam Smith, Stargate, yeah. Taylor Swift, Kanye West, Pharrell Williams.
Yes, yeah,
guys.
Yeah, I just said let the music
guys.
Speak, man. Let the music speak, you know. If we create,
I think there's also a reality behind it.
Yeah,
that you must understand, like, Because you're asking very real questions in the sense of, like, process.
Yes.
Let me give you a real process.
Okay.
What's today? Today's Monday.
No, Thursday.
But I don't really know the day. But when did we arrive from Kenya?
We came at Tuesday.
Monday. Okay, Monday. That's what I was thinking, Monday. Monday we were in studio, right? We've been working this deal for a year, right? Thinking that it's going to happen. Then it's not sure, then it's going to happen, so for a year this has been going on. Monday, we got a call whilst we were in studio making music that the deal has gone through and everything is finalized. And we arrived, we did a show on Tuesday,
yeah.
We had things going on Wednesday, and here we are on Thursday. So to be honest, we haven't really had time to, like, you know, you don't want to arrive too quick. I was going to say come, but you don't know, that sound weird. But you don't want to arrive too quick, you know? You know,
it's more relevant for come.
Yeah. I thought twice, but yeah, you know, so I think we're taking step by step, and I think that the next step is to kind of think a little bit and dream a little bit. But I mean, when you start to mention people like Pharrell Williams, when you start to mention people like Sam Smith from a vocal point of view, you know, you start to dream, you know. But yeah, it's very exciting. I think Craig David's even with Sony, and I'm a huge Craig David fan. I've been a Craig David fan for eons, you know. So, and I know he's not, like, relevant like the other people, but he's still a legend for me. Like, he was a very important part of my story. So I think we'll start dreaming now that it's real. I think that one of the things we've learned is, like, to be patient and to only celebrate something once it's on paper. This is on paper as of today, man. So we'll start dreaming and then we'll let you know.
Yeah, I told you.
But we didn't mention some names. Yeah. Right?
No? I mean, now you look at the list and you're like, okay.
Hands down, out of the names that you briefly mentioned,
yeah,
to one person that we've always spoken about,
yeah,
is Pharrell Williams, just from a production point of view. Like, I always think about, like, what a Mikasa / Pharrell Williams, because he also does that, like, happy, groovy, fun music, and that's what Mikasa does, you know, but with more of like a South African feel. So I always wonder, like, how, what that would sound like. So if that opportunity pops, man, like, it would be amazing.
So how does it work? Do you get like a wish list to say like, yo, these are the people we have access to, give me a wish list, boom, send it through, email it to me.
Yeah, I think we're going to start also understanding how it works now being with a major. We've never been with a major. We were with Soul Candy. You know, Soul Candy was a local house dance label. So it was like, yo, we want to work with DJ Tira. Do you have his contacts? And that's what was the wish list, you know. Yeah. So that was the vibe. And whereas now it's like, yo, we want to work with Pharrell. Do you have his contact? We don't really know how this whole thing works from that point of view, but I think we're definitely looking forward to it. I think it's exciting. Like, we know that our music is traveling to the UK now in the next couple of weeks with Roland, you know, and he's going there to pitch some stuff and pitch some of our dreams that we've put on the floor. So what we do from our end is we will write down things that we wish to achieve, whether it's collaborations, whether it's certain targets within revenues of like amount of sync deals that we want to get or that sort of thing. And then whatever happens, happens. We've never forced anything, right? We've never like tried too hard. But if it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen.
Grace.
Yeah.
I'll wait, guys.
Sorry, guys. Thanks.
Just one more and then you can give us a shout out.
Yes.
And the one more is, in your 7-year career, for like a new artist who's like bouncing into the scene, because I mean, that's who mostly we represent as Hip Hop 411, you know, the guys that are still on the come up. So what sort of learnings from the game, like you said, you're just moving different now, you've learned a whole lot of lessons, especially around publishing, like you guys are saying, which is serious business, you know what I mean? What sort of the lessons that you can like say, yo, here's my 2 cents for what you need to look out for coming up?
I think I'll just touch base on the production or producer side of everything. I think there's a lot of producers out there. You know, everyone these days can be a producer. You know, but now this thing is an art, so you need to spend time. You need to spend time learning all the time, all the angles and everything. You know, you need to master your craft. You know, so that you can be different. You know, it's the same thing, man, as your soccer. You need to go to that pitch, keep the ball to all the angles all the time so that you can get, you know, you can be accurate all the time. You know? So with music, I think my passion has been like, lock yourself in the rehearse, check whatever's out there, what's the sound, how can you change it, how can you bring a new sound onto your production, you know, all the sweet melodies and everything. Because everyone can play a keyboard, everyone can produce, everyone can play bass or drums and stuff, but just spend time so that you can be unique.
Well, Mo, you want to take on that?
I think Dulo said so much. Dulo said so much, like, you know, he mentioned like a bass guy, you know, a guy playing cheese, a guy playing guitars, you know, and everything. But I just really think that everything that's created really counts, you know, and it must also be done with great thoughts, with great passion also. And you know, like, I've always said to the gents also, like, with music, like, I'm out of going to the studio trying to set up, saying, yeah, but this is what's going to happen, I am crazy. You know, but, guys,
have a cookie. Oh, yes.
but really, I just go in there wanting to have fun in the studio, and not going in there saying that I want to make a hit or anything, but it's been something to saying that, you know what, I actually want to make the best sounding ball within me, and then everything else comes later. I just create that great music and that great essence, you know. And yeah, that's it, man.
But what do you say to those kids who want to do a blowjob?
Oh, yeah, no. If they want to blow, you know, they must first make sure that they love blowing. And then after you know that they love blowing, and then to practice blowing the blow. Ha 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 ha!